So question 2 of this exercise says, write down the decimal expansions of those rational numbers in question 1 which have terminating decimal expansions. So this question relies on the numbers given in question 1. So if you want, you can go back to question 1 and take a look at all the numbers given. So let's take a look at those numbers again and what we had concluded about each one. So I had written T to represent terminating and NT, R to represent non-terminating repeating. So of these 10 numbers, the numbers which have terminating representations or terminating decimal expansions are 13 by 3125, 17 by 8, 15 by 1600, 23 by 2 cube into 5 square, then 6 by 15, and then 35 by 50. Now, to write the terminating decimal expansions of each of these rational numbers, we need a multiplier that will convert the denominator in each case into an exact power of 10. So to understand what I mean, let's take the first number, which is 13 by 3125. So if I prime factorize the denominator, I will get 13 by 5 to the power 5. Now the denominator has 5 fives in it and there are no twos. So if I multiply the numerator and the denominator by 5 twos, which is 2 to the power 5, like this, then we can make 5 pairs of 2 and 5 in the denominator and convert it into an exact power of 10. So if we do that, we will get, in the numerator, we will get 13 into 2 to the power 5 or 13 into 32, and in the denominator, we will get 5 to the power 5 into 2 to the power 5 or 10 to the power 5 or 1 followed with by 5 zeros. So 13 by 32 is 13 times 32 is 416. So 416 by 100,000 is 0.00416. So this is the terminating decimal expansion of this first number, 13 by 3125. Now let's take the second number, which is 17 by 8. Now 17 by 8, if I prime factorize the denominator, this is 17 by 2 cube. So once again, I see that the denominator has only twos in it. It has three twos. So if I multiply above and below by three fives, which is 5 cube and 5 cube, then in the denominator, I will end up making 3 pairs of 2 and 5, and I will convert the denominator into an exact power of 10. So what I will get is 17 into 5 cube or 125 in the numerator and 2 cube into 5 cube or 10 cube or 1000 in the denominator. Now 17 into 125 is 2125. So if I divide that by 1000, I will get 2.125. So this is the terminating decimal expansion of the second number. The other way we could have arrived at the same answer is by dividing 17 by 8 using long division. So as an exercise, you can pause this video and do that and see if your answer matches what we have calculated, which is 2.125. Now let's take the third number. The third number was 15 by, the third number with the terminating expansion was 15 by 1600. So 15 by 1600. And if I prime factorize the denominator, I will get 15 by 2 times 6 into 5 square. And if you want, you can verify that the prime factorized form of 1600 is 2 raised to the power 6 and into 5 square. Now the denominator has 6 twos and 2 fives. So all the pairs of 2 and 5 are not complete. So to complete the pairs, I will have to introduce 4 more fives, because there are 6 2s and 2 5s. So I will have to introduce 4 more 5s, or I will have to multiply above and below by 5 to the power 4. So what will this give me? So in the numerator, this will give me 15 times 5 to the power 4, which is 625. And in the denominator, it will give me 2 to the power 6 into 5 to the power 6, which is 10 to the power 6, or 1 followed by 6 zeros. Now 625 times 15, this product is 9375. And when I divide that by 10 to the power 6, I will get 0.009375. So this is the terminating decimal expansion of the third number from the given set, which has a terminating expansion. So three of the parts are done. Now three parts are remaining. So let's do the next one. So the fourth number with a terminating expansion is this number, which is given in part 6, which is 23 by 2 cube times 5 square. So the denominator is already given to us in prime factorized form, and we see that it has 3 2s and it has 2 5s. So to complete all the pairs of 2 and 5, we need to introduce one more 5 into the denominator, and we can do that by multiplying above and below by 5. Now in the numerator, we get 23 times 5, which is 115. And in the denominator, we get 2 cube into 5 cube, which is 10 cube, which is 1000. So let me write it as 10 cube. So now 115 by 10 cube is 0.115. So this is the terminating decimal expansion of this fourth number, which has a terminating expansion. Now let's go to the next number, which is 6 by 15, which was actually in part 8. So this was 6 by 15. Now if you remember my solution to question 1, I had said that we actually first need to reduce it to its lowest form, because there is a factor of 3 in the denominator, but it also occurs in the numerator. So if we first reduce it to lowest form, what we get is 2 by 5. And in this form, we see that this number has a terminating decimal expansion. Now we can write this as, we can write 2 by 5 as, we can multiply above and below by 2. So because I want to make the 5 into a 10, so this will actually be equal to 4 by 10, or 0.4. So 0.4 is the terminating decimal expansion of 6 by 15. Finally, let's come to the last number, which was in part 9 with a terminating expansion. So that was 35 by 50. So 50 has the, so first let me write the prime factorized form of 50. So 50 is 2 into 5 into 5, or 2 into 5 square. So what I can do is I can complete the pairs of 2 and 5 in the denominator by multiplying above and below by 2, and that will give me, in the numerator it will give me 70, and in the denominator it will give me 2 square into 5 square, or 10 square, or 100, and this is equal to 0.70, which is terminating. The other way could have been to first reduce this to lowest form, this number 35 by 2 into 5 square, reduce it to lowest form by cancelling out a factor of 5 above and below. So that would leave 7 in the numerator and 10 in the denominator. So from here itself, we could have written this in lowest form as 7 by 10. And we can see now see that 7 by 10 also has a decimal representation as 0.7, same as 0.70. So you can do this either way. So with that, all the six numbers from amongst the 10 numbers with terminating decimal expansions, we have written their terminating expansions in decimal form. To learn more about how QMath can help you crack school and board exams, explore QMath Leap, a live online classroom program run by highly experienced and committed teachers.